Hello, my name is Mario Scampoli, Senior Client Performance Manager with VinSolutions, and today I'm going to be going through the desking tool, sharing a few tips and tricks on some ways that you can be using it to be a little more efficient and effective, either making things easier or also maybe saving some gross. First thing I wanted to review is this gray dropdown. This will allow us to see how many leads we've received on the unit, as well as how many deals we've worked. Additionally, if you have the profit time integration, you can see your profit time scoring within the desking tool, as well as link directly into Viato right from here. We also have the value button. This would show us if this customer has purchased any vehicles from us in the past at our dealership or other dealerships within the group, as well as what the profitability was on those deals front and back, and if they service with us. All of those can be great indicators on how I might want to present those numbers to the customer and anticipation of back-end profitability to make up for maybe a lower sales price, or maybe we know that at least we'll make it up in service, right? So you can review that to kind of get an idea of what the kind of customer this opportunity presents to us. We also can see if we have an email address or not. If we don't, obviously data capture is very important. You can click right into the customer name and add that email address into here, even opt the customer in if you have manual opt-in available, and hit save, updating that for future follow-up. The other spot I wanna highlight is down in the trade evaluation area. You know, people believe what they see, not what they hear, or not what you write down, you know, with a Sharpie. So you can actually add in recon items that you can default or have selectable. You can change the price on the fly. You can have different options set up. But what this is gonna do is it's gonna show the customer more like the number maybe they saw in Kelley Blue Book, because they probably didn't tell Kelley Blue Book that their car needed tires, but ultimately have something for the salesperson to talk about, right? So that they can have a conversation with the customer to explain why it's 42,000, not 43,500. Otherwise, they're coming back before you take a sip of coffee saying they want more for their trade. So that can help us ultimately get a true value on that vehicle. We also have fuel savings analysis. Potentially, if this customer was at 1248 and they wanted us, do a deal at 1200, maybe we can't get there with our discounting, but maybe we can get there with fuel savings. So I can go in here and I can put in maybe they're trading in a car with 17 miles to the gallon. And you can do a quick Google search to figure out what that number is of their trade, or even get it right off their trip computer, coming in from your trade evaluation. But this vehicle is going to save them, $34 a month in gas, right? So we've almost made up that full 48. Maybe if we said, gas was $3.50 a gallon, right? You can figure out kind of how to manipulate the numbers as well to get that number to closer to where you need it to be. But ultimately, first tanks on us, give me a signature at the bottom, worth a shot instead of just fading our gross. If the number is negative or not enough, it just won't print on the presentation. But both of those data points can actually be printed on the quick print and allow your salespeople to have some information to overcome whatever the objection is, save some profitability for the store, and ultimately make a bigger commission. You also have these blue links up at the top that are very advantageous for a particularly busy Saturday. I can open and close my showroom visits right from here. Johnny walks up, says, hey, I need a pencil. I can make sure the customer has been added in. I can launch desking, or maybe we've exhausted our efforts. Customer's going home to think about it. I can complete my road to the sales steps and even end my showroom visit right within the desking tool. Also have the ability to check for upcoming appointments or confirm them. I can do my tasks from the desking tool. I can even access my dealer hyperlinks and maybe go check to see if I have unanswered communications or clean up active sales, leads, and future follow-up. But regardless, these specific areas of the desking tool can make it more efficient and effective for you when you're busy, and ultimately also hopefully help you make a little bit more money. I hope you found that helpful, and check out the rest of our series.